Thank you very much, dear Stefano, President Rompuy, ladies and gentlemen. For me, it's a real pleasure to be with you today. I'm very happy to see the business side taking a proactive stance and approach towards the conference of the future of Europe. Europe's future can only be shaped successfully if entrepreneurial mindset is added to the recipe. It's in the hands of the employers, businesses, and their representatives to make this happen. The autumn 2021 economic forecast of the Commission showed that the European economy bounces back from the pandemic recession faster than expected. However, we must not forget that these forecasts greatly depend on the evolution of the COVID-19 pandemic. At the EESC this week, we have started a campaign to support EU institutions and national governments to increase vaccination rates. We cannot afford lockdowns becoming the new normal. And let me add here one personal observation. What we see recently on the streets of our cities throughout Europe, these big demonstrations of people, of non-vax, mingling with political radical groups, I see that as a big danger. We have to be careful about that. We have to be aware that this can also hinder really our economic growth, that can be disruptive in the development that we are just facing. Vaccination, for me, it's clearly the best weapon to fight the pandemic, and I would like to invite you to share this message in your respective networks. The pandemic is far from being over. We face economic risks and the pickup in inflation driven also by the surge in energy prices. European entrepreneurs and SMEs are still struggling to survive. Estimates show that in 2020, the number of SMEs fell by 1.3%, with over 90% of SMEs reporting a fall in turnover. European SMEs lost 1.5 million jobs through the crisis. The biggest challenge now is to ensure a balanced recovery throughout Europe while laying down a path towards resilient and a sustainable future. The EESC will remain vigilant in monitoring the implementation of the Recovery and the Resilience Facility and the Next Generation EU. The support must be timely, effective, and fair. It must reach those truly in need. Investments must be leading to structural reforms. To make Europe fit for the future, we cannot just go back to the pre-crisis status quo. We have to support Europe's businesses to get ready for the digital and green transition and build realistic transition paths. In these stormy times, working towards the economic recovery of Europe by ensuring that Europe becomes the most attractive place to start, run, and grow a business should be high on our agenda. It is clear that there is much to do, and Europe needs to use this crisis as an opportunity to redefine itself and determine its future. The Conference on the Future of Europe, you've already said it, Stefano, provides this opportunity. We need to make sure that this whole exercise is not an empty one. We must go beyond the Brussels bubble, listen to our people and businesses, and get them involved. To be credible, people's ideas and requests need to receive a follow-up from the EU decision makers and be turned into concrete action. This is why I propose the creation of a dashboard to show in all transparency what are the proposals and what is the follow-up that is given by the EU institutions. And if no action is taken after some ideas, we should also be able to see the reasons, therefore. Together, we can establish a new narrative for Europe. I fully support and I would like to congratulate you on the timely adoption of the Employers Group Manifesto, making the European Union capable of action on the Conference of the Future of Europe. To mention just some key elements, also the EESC is supporting in our resolution on the future of Europe to make Europe a truly great place to be and to prosper, to enhance Europe's preparedness and response capacity for the future, and to strengthen Europe's strategic autonomy and global competitiveness while remaining open to international trade. I'm looking forward to working with you together to achieve your common goals. Thank you.